Hello, I'm Dr. Stephanie McGregor, and I'm a pathologist with the UW Health Breast Center.
Hi, I'm Dr. Paul Weissman, and I'm a pathologist with the UW Health Breast Center.
If there is an area in your breast that your doctor is concerned about, your doctor will ask for a pathologic examination of this tissue once it has been biopsied.
Most breast lesions or lumps are first sampled by a needle core biopsy, in which a small hollow needle is used to take tissue from the lesion. The tissue is processed overnight so it can be thinly sliced and mounted on glass slides for pathologists to view under a microscope. The UW Pathology Laboratory is accredited by the College of American Pathologists, which ensures that we consistently meet high-quality standards. Our pathologists spend all their clinical time looking at only breast and gynecologic tissue, so they really understand these types of cancer.
Each breast biopsy is examined by at least two pathologists before a diagnosis is issued. It is the pathologist reading your breast tissue that determines your diagnosis, which in turn influences the treatment options available to you. While you may never meet your pathologist, they are a critical member of your care team.
In addition to examining tissue from our patients at UW Health, our pathologists also review slides from other hospitals as second opinions or for confirmation of diagnosis.
The breast is made up of structures called lobules, where breast milk is produced, and ducts that carry breast milk from the lobules to the nipple. Carcinoma, which is the most common type of breast cancer, occurs in either the lobules or the ducts. Rarely, other cancers can form in the tissue around the ducts and lobules.
Pathologists describe cancers in multiple ways. Carcinomas are described as being either in situ or invasive. In situ means that abnormal cells are contained within the structures of the breast, while invasive means abnormal cells have moved beyond the walls of the lobules or ducts and have the potential to move beyond the breast. Invasive carcinoma arises from in situ carcinoma, and many tumors with invasive carcinoma still contain in situ carcinoma as well. Most carcinomas are also classified as being either ductal or lobular.
In addition to diagnosing cancer, pathologists sometimes see precancerous conditions when they examine tissue. Atypical hyperplasia is a precancerous condition that can occur in both the lobules and ducts of the breast. It takes a highly trained pathologist to accurately diagnose a finding as atypical hyperplasia versus an in situ cancer. This is important because of the varied treatment options for atypia versus in situ disease.
In addition to making a diagnosis, our pathologists also perform biomarker studies on the cancer, including evaluation for estrogen receptor, progesterone receptor, and HER2. The results of these markers will help your doctor decide the best treatment for you. Your clinician will discuss your pathology results with you as part of your treatment planning.
In the pathology department, we also look at tissue from surgeries, including lumpectomies, mastectomies, and lymph node excisions that patients undergo as part of their cancer treatment. Here we determine the tumor size and whether cancer has traveled to lymph nodes or is at the edges of the tissue. We share this additional information with the clinical team to determine what, if any, further treatment is recommended. We hope this introduction to breast pathology has been helpful. For more information, please visit our website at uwhealth.org/breastcenter.